breaking news today.
Please subscribe and then check notification box to get all breaking news alert.
Final revenge, mayor of Berkeley just did one thing that will put Antifa in jail. Well, y'all, it finally happened. Antifa has just finally been stabbed in the back by one of their only real allies, the city of Berkeley. Berkeley Mayor Jesse Arreguin gained a backbone and shocked the entire alt-left establishment when he told reporters today. I think we should classify them, Antifa, as a gang.
Should classify them as a gang.
Tough words from Berkeley's mayor about the army of anarchists who took over a peaceful rally while others are defending their violent tactics. Good evening, I'm Veronica Dela Cruz.
I'm Alan Martin. Berkeley's mayor says it is time to confront the violent extremism on the left. Hundreds of black bloc anarchists were seen jumping the barriers, some attacking Trump supporters at yesterday's rally. KPIX5's Phil Matiers in Berkeley with two different takes on the clashes at Civic Center Park. Phil?
That's right, Alan. It's not a new tactic. We've seen it previously both here in Berkeley and in Oakland. Anarchists mixing in with demonstrators, nonviolent, and then springing forth. This is what the mayor had to say about it today.
I think we should classify them as a gang. You know, they come dressed in uniforms, they have weapons, they're almost a militia. I think we need to think about that in terms of our law enforcement approach.
Berkeley Mayor Jesse Arreguin says that he does not support the far right, but that it was time to draw a line on the left as well, especially with the black bloc anarchists who showed up in force and took over both the protest and the park and played a part in yesterday's violent clashes.
I think we're going to have to think big picture about what's the strategy of how we're going to deal with these violent elements on the left as well.
The mayor said it was also time for nonviolent protesters to take a stand as well.
We also need to hold accountable and encourage people not to associate with these extremists because it empowers them and it gives them cover.
Protest organizers today, however, defended Black Bloc's presence.
White supremacists and fascists are not welcome, and that if the state is not going to protect us, and they do not, that we are going to protect ourselves and welcome those who stand with us.
Our news crews found that most of the conservative demonstrators in the park yesterday were Trump supporters who repeatedly denounced Nazis and racists.
I am against the white supremacy.
And while it didn't look good, the mayor also praised Berkeley police for holding back and ceding the park to the anarchists.
Black Bloc was trying to provoke the police. I think since some of the more sort of conservative protesters had already left or were already escorted out safely.
What would you say to the guy that was getting chased down the street?
Well, it's unacceptable. I mean, anyone who was injured, it's completely unacceptable.
Jesus ain't gonna come and be your savior today.
And we are gonna be looking at video. We're gonna be identifying people.
In the wake of Charlottesville and yesterday's troubles in Berkeley, the mayor also called on neighboring UC Berkeley to call off next month's planned free speech week, one that would feature Milo Yiannopoulos, whose last appearance at Berkeley triggered this riot.
I believe that that's the right thing to do. And if they don't do that, then they need to work with the city and potentially assist the city through resources to be able to adequately police what we know is going to be a large protest that will spill out onto the city streets.
However, he did not stop there. Arreguin actually admitted how dangerous the left has become. They come dressed in uniforms. They have weapons, almost like a militia, and I think we need to think about that in terms of our law enforcement approach. Although a militia terrorizing civilians for political ends seems a lot more like a terrorist organization than a simple gang. Still, it is a start. He even called out the mainstream media and the clueless college kids for giving Antifa cover for their sickening crimes against our constitutional freedoms. We also need to hold accountable and encourage people not to associate with these extremists because it empowers them and gives them cover. This is an amazing sign for our country if the most socialist city in the country is turning on their own violent political group. Now let's hold them accountable and make sure Antifa pays for their crimes by sharing this everywhere immediately.